Okay. Probably just gonna be me today, but it's a good way to keep me on track. So, I am going to spend the next little while working on a project that has gotten off track a little bit, but that I was working on harder earlier this summer, just to support variable stretch grids, basically, inside YT. So I'm going to go ahead and get started with that. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to dig up the pull request, and we're going to look at that and go through where things are, refresh our memories. Hope everybody is doing okay out there. It's been a bit of a hard week over here. Okay. I'm going to go on down here and take a look at where things got to. I think basically the process, the last time that I dealt with this, where I was stuck was in how I should implement converting I chords to I res in a general way. And it looks like here, okay, actually, this looks like it's gone reasonably far. Go back here and take a look at how things are looking. I doubt that I still have the pre-commit result. Oh, I do. Flake 8. Missing white space after comma. Line 459. I'm going to see if I can rerun excuse me. I'm going to go ahead and commit this one change, and then we'll go ahead and looks like I was having issues with this before where it's. I'm on Pi 310. Yeah. So this happens to me every once in a while where, okay, one file left unchanged. Let's take a look at this. Well, I guess I'll have to make some more substantive changes if I really want to get it to rerun. So, gonna turn my preview off here. Let's see. Gonna go ahead and I'm probably gonna use my probably gonna use the terminal mostly for testing today. Rebuild it. Okay, so just to review, we've got our I chords to F chords. This should be implemented in our projections. Let me take a look at where I. Got to with the load stretched grid. Yeah, let's take a look at this. Okay. So I'm going to open up load stretched grid. So we're generating some random density data. Yeah, that's, you know, that's kind of how we do it. As well as some random cell widths. We're loading it up here. And then we're taking a look at our unique values. So that should give us, and I believe that I ported all this into the tests. So we're going to take a look at what happens if we project along it. We should be able to project the field ones. And when we save it out, it should be uniform. So let's take a look. You know what? Let's go ahead and we'll do this for each of our axes. Did I not save it? There we go. Yeah, look at that. They are almost all uniformly zero. This is just the anti-aliasing mixing things up. So that's good. All right, let's take a look now at, and actually, you know what? I'm going to take a look. We'll do this p.save, and then we'll do p. Let's see, this is our plot. Ones. Wow, all these type annotations are really helping out, actually. Okay. I can't remember the... Here, you know what? Let's... It's taking me a little while to get into the groove today. I hope you'll forgive me a little bit. So I think this, yeah. Is it buffer? More to the point, why am I forgetting all this stuff? Oof. I don't think it's image. Is it really projection? Oh, that's something different. Okay, so init image aspect plot valid projection create axes set font properties. All right. Well. Let's move on. We're going to go ahead and I'm going to take a look at the tests for stretched grids. Looks like here, index dx, yeah, okay, so here we're just asserting that these things are all equal. I wonder why I didn't put these in a loop. I'm sure if I went back and watched, I'd find it, but. Let's see. So we're already testing that all of it is operative there. It kind of looks to me like we're a lot closer than I thought. So maybe the thing to do here is test this out with a data set. I'm going to go ahead and oh, you know what? I forget. Does nose not work with Py 3.10? Maybe it's 3.11 that it doesn't work with. Well, let's get back to this. So we've got our stretched grid here, and I think if I look at files changed, let's see, did I add any documentation for this? I didn't. You know what? That'd be a good place to go. So I'm going to start by writing up a little bit of documentation inside our to describe how to do a load stretched grid. So let's go ahead. To loading data. This is loading sample data, AMR vac. For stream data, for more detail, semi-structured grid data. Let's go down here. Add a note. Efficient way. I forget exactly how many spaces I'm supposed to put before this, but no. Rest always confuses me. Let's see. Let's just go back to Vim. Okay, so looks like here, okay, so I don't put the note on the same line, right. This is done via the, and here let me do func tilde yt dot front ends. Stream.datastructures.load stretched grid. Oh, uniform grid operation supplying the this needs two backticks. Using hexahedral mesh is no longer suggested for situations where the mesh can be adequately described with three arrays of cell widths. So this is load semi-structured. Now I'm going to also say C ref loading stretched grids for more information. So here we go. Stretched grid data. Now I think right now we still only allow specifying the it for one root grid. So let's take a look at that and see. Honest, it's been a little bit tricky to concentrate on things with everything going on lately. But let's give it a shot. Okay, stretch grid data. With YT4.1, and this might change, it may not get released in 4.1. This allows situations, and I don't know why it's not wrapping at the correct word length here, but whatever. I'm genuinely curious, or I'm genuinely unsure how long the YT doc situation is going to stay the way that it currently is, just because I think at some point we're going to get to the point where it'll be more efficient to either store them in a separate format or, I don't know, maybe use like JupyText, something like that. But since this is one of the few places that we use restructured text nowadays, instead of Markdown, I suspect it's not going to last forever. A grid has a functional form for its make sure that I'm saying things that are true here, because one thing I can't remember is, if we look at grid geometry hint, you know what? I looked at the projection, but one thing I didn't check was I did not check let's annotate the cell edges. And we'll project, yeah, we'll project ones. We'll set the zlim to 0.9 and 1.1. Is that load stretch grid? Yeah. Sorry, I'm trying to remember which keyboard shortcuts do which. Again, oh, yeah, that's wrong, isn't it? Okay, so let's go back here. grid geometry handler has this I chords to F chords situation. Now what we're seeing here, Well, we do have some development to do today on this. It is not where I thought it would be. And we can see that if we were to do the same thing here, the slice plot. If I do a slice plot of these things, and we'll go back to, I don't know how to say it, but I think it's Geeky. See the difference between them. So these are the projections, but these are the slices. So we're doing, these are all random values, and you'll see that here it's pretty uniform. Here it's absolutely not. So we got to get back here. So I chords to F chords. I chords and I res, axes equals none. What we need to do is we need to have the ability to specify our cell widths, which in general either means taking our I chords and our I res. All right, let's go back to our stream data structures. Now let's see, where do we store our cell widths? Stream stretch grid. So in our stream handler, we've got a stream hierarchy. So grid cell widths. Interestingly, this is not specific to our grid, to having a unigrid. So def, but I bet it'll break with nproc greater than one. Something to keep in mind. So let's go back here. So we've got our, we're going to overload this, I chords to F chords. Why is it, okay, so VS Code does this to me every so often. I really don't know what is happening, but it gets extremely slow, and it does this mostly in Python. I haven't really seen it in TypeScript. I wish I understood why, but it gets very slow after a while when I queue a bunch of stuff up into the keyboard buffer. Okay, we check here that we have cell widths, and if we do, we will provide them. Excuse me. So, we're just going to do one very simple check. This is only going to work if we have a single grid. If self.grid cell widths is not none, and len self.grid cell widths dot shape. No, it'll be a length. So now it's going to be an array of three, or it's going to be a list of three, I think. Let's take a look at load stretched grid here. Cell widths is cell width. Cell widths is a list. This is going to need to be changed. It's going to need to be a list of lists. But so we'll go back over here, cell widths. we'll leave it for now because we've got tests that depend on it. If it's none, then we will go up to our return super I chords to F chords I chords I res axes. So we'll call the super method, which will then by default pass back over to here. If not, then we will figure it out using our cell widths. So we've got I chords, which gives us our zero index into our cell widths. So we're first going to have pause is equal to, we're going to need to center these eventually. So how do we, I think I have a functional form of that somewhere, but these F chords need to be centered. So our stretched grid. Self centers is equal to self dot left edge I So we gotta compute our cell centers. Domain left edge. So that'll give us our cell centers. See, I typed all this, and now it's taking like a ridiculous amount of time for it to go through. I don't know why it's doing that, but it kind of makes me not want to use VS Code for this. So I might not. I guess we'll see. This should have an open bracket. Okay, now, oh, you know what? Maybe it's because there was a typo. Anyhow. Coordinates is equal to np.array cell centers 0 I chords Now this will not work uniformly. This will work for a single grid, but it will not work in the case that where we have AMR or where we're doing any type of grabbing of stuff. So this has to return our position and DDS. So our position here, chords, and this is, we need to specify, we need to select axes, and then cell widths are going to be self.cellWidth, it's going to be the array of self.cell widths 0 I chords everything comma 0 indexed with our I chords 0. Yeah, okay, now self.cell widths. What is that? it's 1, I chords, colon, comma, 1, self.cell widths 2, I chords, colon, comma, 2. So that should get us our array. Okay, now what's happening? It broke on... It's not able to format with black, so it's getting confused somewhere. Do I have an unclosed parenthesis or something? What? There we go. It did it. All right, so now this grid cell widths. Yes, I did actually. This mistake. There we go. Okay, this is where we get somewhere. Can't multiply sequence by non-int of type float. Self.grid cell widths 0. Oh, all right, well, I guess what I had already, this is fun. This is only going to work for a single grid, yeah. But it looks like we can do it, because it's already regarding them as arrays of arrays. That seems wrong. Oh, dang it. Okay. So here, we've got these axes. So coordinates equals np dot array. This is where things get a little bit tricky because I need to slice both of them simultaneously. So let's take a look at what axes is. Yeah, axes is 1. Each of these is all these cell centers should be the same size, shouldn't they? No, they wouldn't be. Yes, they would. So we'll do cell centers. No, they wouldn't necessarily be. So this is where things get really, really irritating. This would be so much better. Oh, hey, thank you. Well, yeah, thank you. I will give a shot at that. Maybe next time I'll do a stream of some fun hacks for this. I have to say that at times I'm not super duper pleased with my usage of VS Code. I feel like I'm leaving a lot on the table, as it were, but yeah, it would be pretty fun. I'd like to hear about what other people do as well. All right, let me see. So we've got our coordinates here. This is, so the cell centers issue is actually going to be really difficult. The axes here, I don't want to have to undo all of the slices. So instead, one possibility would be to do a stacking of an array. So let's try this. So NumPy, if we've got three arrays of variable length, we need something kind of like mgrid. So I want to say, so there's a way to do this in NumPy. And I think actually if I look in the docs for mgrid, it will tell me what that way is. Because basically we need to take this and turn it into mesh grid. Yep, it is. So np.meshgrid. Okay. So chords equals np.meshgrid cell centers. We will say axes here. So this is not super duper efficient because we're creating a bunch of arrays that we will sub-select from later, immediately. But now we can do I-chords. DDS, I think we can do the exact same thing. So np.meshgrid self.grid cell widths 0 axes I chords. Let's try this. Now, if we've got our loading of our stretched grids, this should, list indices must be integers or slices, not tuple. All right, let's take a look at this. np.meshgrid cell centers. Okay, so axes. Wait a second. All right. So I actually need to do star cell centers. There we go. Let's take a look at what this gives us. Okay, now I think if I do yeah, all right, well, I think this will still not work if I do that, but I should be able to do np.stack mesh grid star cell centers. Access equals minus one should give me, okay. Still doesn't quite do it because I need it to be flattened after that. Let's go back here because think yeah, all right, I'm going to let's take a step back. I need to describe exactly what I'm trying to do because I realize that I've gone pretty far into this without without describing where we are. Basically, the whole point of what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to make it so that we can convert our I coordinates into our F coordinates. Our I coordinates are an array, which may or may not have multiple dimensions to it. So it might just be all x I coordinates, might be all y I coordinates, but it might also be x y or x z or something like that. So we need to be able to take our I coordinates and access them. We need to be able to take them and turn them into the other thing, or into floating point values. So I'm wondering now if maybe I should be using the stride trick in order to. There's a way to convert this slice into a set of indexes. It's the array concatenator. Cell centers is equal to domain left edge axes, and we can copy that right out of here. Axes, comma, plus accumulating the grid cell widths, that's zero, So we will set this in order to be our base. Now let's take our axes object. If axes is none, axes equals 0, 1, 2. Else axes, otherwise axes is always going to be a tuple of values, so we can iterate over it. For x in axes, no, actually cell centers equals np.array. Do this x plus this on x for x in axes. Okay, there we go. Does that, nope, doesn't work. There we go, cell centers. And actually that doesn't need to be an array. So let's get rid of that. DDS is equal to those are the cell centers. All right. I think I'm getting this. Take this. DDS. We're just going to have our cell widths. X. So this again, something is breaking here. I'm not sure what, but it's giving me. That was not closed. What about that one? There we go. Four x and x's. Okay. So that gives us our DDS. Now we need to eventually get these into being an array. So here, our cell centers, grid cell widths, coordinates will be cell centers. Yeah, now DDS is actually grid cell widths. Axes, and then we just select I chords. And I don't think we need this anymore. Only integer scale, yeah, of course. Well, all right, let's take a look. I'm just going to unroll the darn loop. Now, so the situation that we find ourselves in now is our cell centers, which is a list of one-dimensional arrays. Needs to be turned into an array. So if we iterate over for I in range I chords shape 0. chords.append. Cell centers. This is not the right way to do this, but cell centers x, I chord I comma x, or x in axes. See which one it is. Oh yeah, I don't actually need to do that. I chords I J or underscore four. Underscore x in enumerate axes. So we don't know which order the axes are going to come to us in, so I got to make sure that they come in that order. I chords dot shape. Okay, axes. Not defined. What? You know what? It's actually not iterating over axes. It's just over this for. They're going to be in the exact same order. DDS, cell widths, axes. And actually, that's going to need to be the exact same thing. So cell widths dot append, self dot grid cell widths. This is all going to need to be in Cython eventually. Underscore I chords I comma underscore for x and enumerate axes. Yeah, I really do think this will need to be in Cython at some point. Either that or someone cleverer than I am can try doing this. Yeah, it's gonna, yeah, there we go. The save didn't quite work in time. Okay, so now we're getting a result. Let's take a look at what that result looks like. And actually, afterwards, I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna change n equals 32. And we'll replace 128 with n globally. Let's take a look at these images. Whoa. Projections are getting a lot different. drop it down considerably. So instead of 32, let's just make this 8. That should allow us to see it. So we're getting blank spots here. I think these are both of the X's. The projections obviously are coming out incorrectly, but I think it's because, and if you look here, you see that this is the, these are low, these are high, so something is getting mixed up, and I suspect we can fix that. So let's go back here to our data structures. If axes is none, axes equals 0, 1, 2, okay. This is the cell center. Coordinates are empty. So the coordinates take our cell centers, which are already set up in our axes. Index them with our I coordinate. What shape are these? What if I transpose them? I often end up in a situation where I need to transpose the. I'm just going to leave G key running in the background. So these are the two that we need to compare. And what I kind of am noticing is that along the x-axis, you'll see that they are all basically the same. I think the x-axis is correct, but what about the y-axis? The y-axis is not. Here, the x-axis is correct, again, but with the x-axis, of course, being along the, what is the y of the plot. So my guess is I've done something weird and incorrect with how I'm setting up the axes, because we're selecting our axes differently. So, for ax in axes, so there's some place I'm using ax when I shouldn't be. For I in range of the shape, so cell centers, let's have cell centers be always 3 long. Cell widths is self dot, oh yeah, the grid cell widths I was doing incorrectly anyway. Why can't I undo more than that? Okay, whatever. So if I go back here and do ax there, for ax in axes. So So this, so the cell grid cell width never changes its shape, so it always needs to be X. Okay, I suspect this will make it work. Let's take a look. What? Okay. Awesome. Okay. So this is not super duper fast. I will say that it's possible that it could get a lot faster if somebody were able to construct, you know, like slice tricks or something like that, instead of allowing it to be unrolled like this. But I can't think of how to do that offhand. So I'm going to go ahead and check this in. Check this in. That's a very old, that's what you used to say in Subversion and CVS days. I'm going to commit this. I'm going to set up this. This is just going to be a stub for now. Loading stretched grids. I'm going to check that in, or I'm going to commit that. And then I'm going to push this up. Oh yeah, it's got to initialize everything. I'm kind of pleased with this. Pleased with where I got today. I'm genuinely pleased. I do want to see this speed up, but this should be enough to get basic stretched grids loaded. You know what? I'm going to see if I can flesh out this a little bit more. See if I can get the documentation up to speed, and we can release it maybe as a preliminary with YT 4.1. So just as a note, what's happening right now, and let me see if I can pull up my debug. But you'll note that right here, allow stream to project, it's still committing. Because it's not the debug, it's here. Oh wow. Gives me all those cool things. I believe that right now it is still initializing my environment for running Black and Flake 8 and all that stuff, because it's a little bit out of date. I don't think that I've initialized it for this. So let's go back here, get 1607. Yeah, that was when I did it. Still staging. Hopefully next time it won't be the same. Or won't be the same time for that, but let's see, log main. Cannot import name Unicode fun. Okay, well, let me hook ID Black Jupiter. You know what? I'm pretty sure that that's I'm gonna force this. Alright, this is tricky because I'm reasonably certain that what I should have done before I committed was update all the different was update from main, but now I'm kind of stuck. So let's stash this. Yep, stash that, stash that, stash that. Okay, now git pull upstream main. Okay, now we stash pop. Now we stage these as soon as they show up. Oops, don't want to test BigEndian gadget. Data structures. And loading data. Those are the two files. So now let's commit. Now, this should have gotten us around the issues I was running into a moment ago when I couldn't get it to commit. Oh hey, how's it going, Schwarzschild HS? Good to see you. I'm doing okay. I hope you're also doing okay. Looks like I am just about ready to end the stream for today, though, because I just got to where I was hoping to with this. I'm now able to project, and here I can show this. I can project. See, this is more impressive than it might seem because I'm now we're projecting irregularly spaced data using just integers for positioning, which is pretty fun. We go up here and go to this pull request, and let's see if I can add a comment to it. Comment. Projections now work, although work with streaming with stream data. Although I would like to see better functional forms implemented. I'm working on the documentation, and then we might be able to call this feature. Preliminary. Okay. Looks like pre-commit's queued. Hopefully that'll run fine. And I think with that, I am going to call it a day. I do appreciate the company. I hope folks are doing okay. I was having a pretty bummer day earlier. Not really sure if that's going to change anytime soon, given the news, but hope folks are doing all right. Oh, glad to meet you too. Yeah, feel free to reach out sometime, and we can chat. Oh, hey, Alex. Yeah, so I hope everybody has an okay day. See ya.